When you go to Kabaka's palace here, there is a gate called Wankachi. So the member group, Wankachi, Wankachi, oh, oh, oh. But you ask the rules, they will tell you what Wankachi is. It means gate. But the problem is that you are parasites. Are not looking for linkages among our people, they are looking for differences. For me, I'm looking for linkages, for them, they are looking for differences. I'm looking for similarities, they are looking for differences. So therefore, the NRM position is how, then you get the laws of Arun, Achori, Lango, these are speaking one language. My knowledge of law was moving very well, but I made a mistake of appointing two commands as my private secretaries. They are the ones who have confused me. Because the kumam, they are not a real person, they are just there. But when I had one of my girls, Pachunega, the ones of my law was moving very well. But you will find law, even the Padoras, even the Raila Odinga in Kenya, in Tanzania, there are laws there, in Tanzania. So, then on top of all this, we have Swahili. Swahili, which is a neutral language. The other day I was asking the president of Tanzania, I said, but these bad words, how did they get into Swahili? Because sometimes I watch Tanzanian TV, like when recently when they were burying Magufuli. You see the words? Mwili, mwili, meaning the body, mwili. Kuaga, wanawaga. Kuaga. These are Runyankore words. Omebuyi, okuraga, kuja, kuja, kuja. So I was asking the president of Tanzania when she was here the other day, I said, but how did these words, pure Runyankore words, get in Swahili? Do the tribes at the coast, because Swahili was developed by the tribes at the coast. Do they have these words? And I was surprised. Apparently, these tribes at the coast in Mombasa and Bagamoyo and Dar es Salaam, apparently they have the same words. Like we have Omobili. Of course, for us here in England, we wouldn't say, a dead body would not say, Omobili would say, we have another word, Omulambo. We have another word. But you can understand what we are talking about. So we have Swahili, Swahili which is a neutral language. So the line of the NRM is, you people of Africa, how can we ensure prosperity for ourselves? What factors do we need? And how can we ensure strategic security for ourselves? And in doing all that, how can we use the fraternity of the African people, which is there, but nobody is using? Even the scholars at McKinsey, they don't look for the linkages among the people, they are looking for differences. A professor in differences. He gets gets a PhD in looking for differences. So this is point number one, which I hope to do, and I ask you, Omolo, make sure my comrades here get this booklet, Nelson Mandela Memorial Lecture, that's what they call it. Because in this one, I trace the whole journey of Africa. So that tomorrow, when I speak, I refer to this. Then last year, 2020, I gave a paper to the National Conference when we met at Nambole. That paper also, they should get a copy, each one, so that they read overnight, and then we see how we can understand together the challenges we are facing. Now, from seeing this, then we shall come to the four principles, which Kasoro Lumumba was talking about. Patriotism, why love Uganda, Pan-Africanism, why love Africa, socio-economic transformation. Those people who have must change. Those villagers, your villagers there, must change. That's what Dr. Lumumba was telling you. In the 1960s, and in this book of this essay for the conference of NRM last year, I traced how I struggled with the Runyankore to change. You cannot continue having pre-industrial people in an industrial age. How can you be prosperous? Number two, strategic security. How can Africa be secure? These are the two big, big challenges. How to be prosperous and how to be secure. But in all that, how do we use fraternity of the Africans? Because the African people are fraternal. They are linked. The African population, is now 1.3 billion people, but they are only divided into four groups. When you listen to these parasites who are all over the place, you will hear that Africans, the differences, the tribes. But when you, like for instance, when I'm in Uganda here, in the Bantu areas, most of the time I don't speak in English. When I'm in Shijezi, those Wachiga speak Runyankore in a bad way, but I can hear. Then I go to Ankore, then I go to Toro, but Toro also speaking Runyankore in a slightly different way. Then I go to Munoro, then I go to, I don't need a translator, I go to Musoga. The Soga speak Runyankore with the Then I even go to the Bagore. Bagore are beautiful people. They are the ones who talk to me, Okore Chibachonka. Even in Usanya, I can pick. You need to listen more carefully. But I don't need a translation. You know, then the ones in Tanzania, Kinyarwanda, Kirundi, I don't need a translation. I can just understand. That's what language means. If you can understand what somebody is saying, even if he's saying in a slightly different way, then that is one language. But your parasites will tell you, Amawanga. Then you go to Luo. Luo, first of all, many words of Luo, you find them in the Bantu dialects. Like, for instance, the word for daughter in Luo is called Nyara. Now, the Bantu speakers, don't you know what that one is? Then you come to like there's a tree called Omtubo. When you go on Guru Road, you'll find Katugo. There's a place called Katugo at mile 62 from Kampala. You ask the real speakers what Tugo means. They will tell you. It's a palm tree. Yes. Omtubo. That's exactly what we call it in Luo.